So as the children go around, young people go around and collect money, this money does go to support the ministry for the children. Penny Duff has our children's story today.
Cleaned it really good, and he put antibiotic ointment on it and packed it all up, and whew, I didn't get lockjaw. I was so relieved. And it healed. It healed up. And one day I was laying back in the barn again, and I looked over at that hole, and I thought, I bet you I could do that again. So I went over to that hole, and I looked down. Yep, there's some bales of straw down there. So I sat down, just like I did before, and with my hands, I couldn't do it now, but I lifted myself down, and I reached with my feet, and I can't find those straw. And so I pulled myself back up. You know what I did? I probably brought my foot up on that same rusty nail, and I had two holes now in my foot. And so I thought, for sure I'm going to get lockjaw this time, and I'm going to, oh my goodness, I limped across the hay mow, back down the side, and I limped all the way across the yard into the house, but my dad wasn't home, so I had to do it myself. And so I cleaned it all out, I did just what he did, and it healed. And so you know what happens when you get a wound like that? It leaves a scar, right? So here is my scar, okay? There's one right there, and this is the first one, and then this is the second one. It's about an inch away from the first one. You just put a hole, and can you see my scar right there? There's one right, it's hard to see now because they're really cool.
I want to see. Gilbert says he can't see it.
Anyways, did you see my scars? Yeah. Right there is one, and there is one. Okay, this is the first one. So anyways, scars. Do you all have scars?
I do.
Do you have scars? And when we have a scar, we can look at that scar and we can remember what happened. So even though this scar happened like over 50 years ago, it's still there. Now it's faded, but it's still there. Good. And so now I was looking at my foot, and I was thinking about that day, or those two times that I did that silly thing. And I thought, you know, my friend Jesus has scars on his, he's got scars in both of his feet and in his hands, big ones, big nails. They went through both of his feet. It was nothing like this, nothing like this. And why does he have those scars in his hands and in his feet? What happened? But, yeah, he got nailed to the tree, the cross. He got nailed to the cross. And when Jesus comes, our scars are going to be gone, right? I'm not going to have any scars anywhere. I've got scars here and there. I'm not going to have any scars. But Jesus is still going to have his scars on his hands, both of his hands and his feet. And when he says, come on, Brianna, let's go to Mars today. And you're going to see those scars in his hand. And you're going to remember the reason why he has those scars in his hand. Because he loves us so much that he came and died on the cross for our sins. And if I was the only person who ever sinned in this whole world, he would have died just for me. And I find that so hard to believe. But he died for all of us. All of us. And when we go to heaven, our scars are going to be gone. But we're going to see the scars in Jesus' hands and in his feet. We're going to remember why he got those scars and how much he loves us. So that's what our service is today about. We're praising God. because of that wonderful sacrifice that he made for us, because he loves each one of you so much. And I want to tell you something, we love you too. Okay, we here in our church love you guys, you kids. So you can go back to your seat now. Thank you so much.